1999, IBM rebadged the Palm 5 and 5X with the WorkPad C3. Palm were making such high-quality personal digital assistants that IBM were willing to put their name on them. These are enterprise-quality devices, and you could almost say that IBM were the business variant of Palm PDAs. And I must say, I love the black casing. I showed off my Palm 5X on the channel back in 2021. After replacing the battery in that video, this 5X then went on to become part of my everyday carry and came with me everywhere. The 5X became for me kind of a refuge from modern devices, a sanctuary away from the confusion of modern technology. Lately though, I've stopped carrying it as I prepare some intriguing new devices that I hope to feature in a future video. In the meantime though, I've decided to get this IBM WorkPad up and running, testing some new apps and doing some special customizations. After being so used to the Palm 5X, the WorkPad's matte black feels almost monolithic, an archetype of technology that I've mentioned in several previous videos. These grayscale Palm OS devices usually include an electroluminescent backlight. This backlight is extremely dim compared to later LED backlights, but in a very dark room when your eyes have adjusted, it's very usable, and I really love its soft blue-green glow under these conditions. I didn't show the backlight much in my first Palm 5X video, but this time I will. This IBM WorkPad was gifted to me by friend of the channel and IBM enthusiast, Benjamin Argic. Thank you, Benjamin, for this wonderful piece of history. It's currently running the German version of Palm OS 3.5, so I'm going to attempt to convert this to English by flashing a new ROM. For reflashing, I'll be using Windows 98 on my period-accurate Sony Vaio laptop. I've got my original Palm 5X dock plugged into the serial port and ready to go. For software, I've installed the proper Palm desktop software for the time. I've also installed the optional Palm OS 4.1 upgrade utility. This should upgrade the OS and convert this unit to English in the process. But this is when I first run into some trouble. The upgrade utility is telling me this software does not match the model I'm attempting to upgrade. Is this because this is the IBM version of the Palm 5X? Fortunately, the upgrade utility includes an advanced option. This mode should bypass this check and flash any version of Palm OS into any Palm OS compatible device. To get this to work, I will have to reset the WorkPad into a low-level firmware bootloader. A handy tip for these models is there's a hidden reset pin kept inside the stylus. Just unscrew the top of the stylus, and there it is. Then, while holding the down button, press the reset hole, and you should see a glitched screen, indicating the device is now ready for reflashing. The desktop software detects this, and then I get a warning pop-up telling me this ROM image may not be compatible. But with very little to lose at this point, let's just do it. There it goes. It looks like it's going to take several minutes. The LCD on the WorkPad is constantly updating with what looks like firmware code as it comes in over the serial port before being flashed into the ROM. I'm really curious about why they made the firmware update process look like this, instead of something more polished like a progress bar. I do really like it though. I think I can occasionally see what looks like distorted graphics information coming through. As the flashing process gets near the end, notice the area of the LCD that was previously updating is now blank, even as the progress bar on the computer keeps going. I think this is actually an empty section of the firmware that is being flashed. This is important, and why this is going to come up later in this video. But then suddenly at 95%, I get an alarming message with an error, saying the flashing process has been interrupted. I tried the retry button, and fortunately after a few retries, the progress bar suddenly jumped to 100%, and the workpad looks like it's now booting up. There it is, the new Palm OS logo. So something has changed. And there it goes. I can calibrate the touchscreen, and everything seems to be working. I've now got my IBM workpad in English, and it's looking great. And the first thing I want to do right now is activate the Easter egg hidden in the operating system. To do this, I just need to go to the General Preferences screen and draw a tiny circle in the bottom right-hand corner. This took a few goes to get right, but when I was finally able to get it done properly, an image of an Easter egg appears. I've been using Palm OS devices for a really long time, but only just found out about this Easter egg. And now with Easter egg mode activated, I can draw a line on the graffiti area to bring up the hidden Easter egg taxi that drives across the screen. Now, although Palm OS 4.0 or 4.1 are good versions of Palm OS, most of the improvements with these versions are for things that I don't really need for this model, such as support for external memory cards, which this model doesn't even have a memory card slot. So I'm going to try downgrading back to Palm OS 3.5. This is the version I'm used to on my original Palm 5X, but more importantly for what I'm doing today, without some of these extra additions in the operating system, this should also mean there's some more empty space available in the internal flash chip. Okay, that was easy. There's no errors from the flashing process this time. Everything looks good, and the workpad reboots immediately. Downgrade has been successful. Now it's finally time to load some software onto this thing. I just need to press the hot sync button and off it goes. I'm transferring about 6 megabytes of software onto this, but it's still going to take a while because everything has to be transferred over the serial port. This workpad, like the Palm 5X that it's based on, contains 8 megabytes of RAM. All the user software and all the information that this unit holds is saved to and directly executed from the RAM. This is a volatile system. If the batteries ever go flat, everything is wiped. It's very important to sync your device regularly with your computer just in case. However, what I'm interested in today is that there's also a 2 megabyte flash memory chip inside this model that is used to hold the operating system. Not all Palm OS capable devices contain a flash memory chip. Some contain a mask ROM for the operating system. Only the models with flash memory can have their OS updated. Okay, that took about 15 minutes. But it looks like all the software that I want to try out has been transferred over successfully. Normally the flash memory that holds the OS is off limits to the end user, but by using some special third-party apps, it's actually possible to gain access to and use any free space in the flash memory to store your own apps and information. That's one of the things I'll be doing today. There are actually a few different programs that can unlock the flash memory. The one I'm using today is called JackFlash. When first running it, this will modify the operating system to gain access to the flash. And look at that. There's 575 kilobytes free in the flash that I now have access to. That's just over 1/4 of the total flash memory just sitting there empty. Now, I just need to find software that I want to store in here. I'm going to start exploring possibilities by reviewing a couple of my favorite games. The first is Bejeweled. I didn't show off this game in my original Palm 5X video, because this game is best played on color screens. But looking at it now, I'm actually quite impressed by how well the gems are differentiated on this grayscale screen. Even so, I probably won't be keeping this game on this device. It's just nice to see it. One of my favorite games that I will be keeping on here is Zap 2000. I think this game looks amazing in both color and grayscale. This is one of Astroware's best games, and it just plays so well. I would put this game up against any OG Game Boy game anytime. It's always a blast and simply never gets old. However, this game is 200 kilobytes, which if added into the flash, would take up a large amount of the precious free flash space. So I probably will keep this game in volatile RAM. I'm also going to be using another program called JackSprat. This software can remove the inbuilt applications that come with the operating system to free up even more precious flash memory. You might have wanted to do this, for example, if you prefer to use, say, a third-party calculator program, and you find you're no longer using the inbuilt calculator. You can then use JackFlash to replace the original calculator with one of your own choosing. But I want to do some heavy customization, so I'm going to use JackFlash to simply remove all the inbuilt applications, except of course for the main launcher program. I'm going to start from scratch and build up the system that I want. Okay, I've removed the inbuilt apps. This has given me a whopping just over 1 megabyte of free flash memory. This is more than enough to really start customizing my WorkPad C3. Just the way I want it to be. I'm going to start by adding some necessary system utilities. The first is Files, an excellent file manager that gives you a lot of control over the operating system and any software that's been installed. I also have a couple of smaller tweaks, one that activates the full 16-bit grayscale mode on the launcher screen to make the icons look nicer. And I also have a small program here that can invert the backlight if I want dark on light instead of light on dark. I'm also going to add the awesome Afterburner overclock utility into the flash memory. The default CPU speed on this model is 20 MHz, which, if I run a nice little 3D test utility, shows the CPU can only manage about 0.8 frames per second with this Quake character. This is not a powerful system, and it wasn't designed with 3D graphics in mind. But by activating the overclock at up to 54 MHz, with some optional system tweaks and speed-ups included, I can get a very generous overclock on this system. The benchmark utility is now showing this is running much faster than stock. Back in the 3D renderer, and I'm getting a huge boost to well over 3 frames per second. Okay, maybe that's not game ready, but there are some games that do benefit on a faster system like this. One such game is the brand new Palm OS game that was released only a couple of weeks ago called StarGrid. It's free and it's available now. Simply pop over to palmdb.net and you can find a copy right there. Now, the author does recommend on running this on color screen Palm OS devices, but I can't wait to try this out for the first time. I think it's been designed with faster Palm OS models in mind, but the overclock definitely does help to make it more playable on here. Another piece of software that I'm keen to try with the overclock is not a game, it's a maze demo. I really like seeing devices like this being pushed to the limit with 3D graphics like this. In the past, I've shown some other very cool 3D programs. I find all this is amazing because this is simply not intended as a 3D capable platform. Another game I want to show off in this video is a port of Rayman in grayscale. It's amazingly smooth, even running at stock clock speeds. I have shown Rayman running on Palm OS devices before in previous videos, but these were much faster color screen models. I had no idea they made a specific version for early grayscale-based Palm OS devices. It's amazing how many platforms they ported this game to. I've even played this game on a Nokia 9210 in a video from almost exactly a year ago. Okay, it's fun to play these games, but I have to stay on track and keep customizing my workpad. I want this beautiful IBM WorkPad C3 to be a highly personalized refuge from the world of modern devices. A place that I can keep customizing to my liking and make it feel like it belongs just to me. I have a lot more software that I want to go through and decide which ones I want to burn into the flash memory. But there is one software that I know I definitely want stored in the flash, and that's this very simple text and ebook reader capable software. One of the things I most enjoyed when I was carrying my Palm 5X was the ability to store and read articles on its beautiful grayscale LCD without needing to use a phone with all its suspect distractions. Every year on my 5X, I would most enjoy reading futurists Bruce Sterling and John Lipkowski's State of the World discussions that would be hosted every year on The Well. The Well is an online community that has existed since the 1980s and still continues to this day, and it's just such a perfect pairing with this device. I may not always agree with the things being discussed here, but there's one thing for sure. Their discussion style really makes me think about how and where things might be going in the future. I've grown increasingly uneasy with the direction that big tech companies are taking artificial intelligence. Like many of you, I'm now having to spend more time curating my YouTube feed, filtering out the noise. And behind the scenes, I've seen my own work being used to train AI models without my consent. And even something as simple as finding meaningful music that I want to put into these videos has become extra difficult. I've been thinking recently about these things more deeply, and where these issues might affect this channel, and where this could lead. But I promise, as AI continues to seep into the gaps, this channel will always remain a refuge from the ills of hypnosis coming from our modern machines.